Webster has always been a place that focuses on lifelong learning.
Pushing oneself out of his or her comfort zone really allows one to not only feel rejuvenated, but also just to continue to keep that fire and that passion alive.
I think it elevates us as individuals and helps challenge who we are and what we do.
If you want to influence change from wherever you are, you need to know what you are influencing, you need to understand what you need to change.
Really, the key thing to think through is not what's the importance of learning, it's what's the importance of being intentional about learning.
Well, this year I was promoted to the Director of Forensics.
Taking on the task of being the program lead for the cybersecurity programs.
Got my degree in management and leadership with a certificate in change leadership.
Studying in the communication management program.
Being a part of the Global Leadership Academy.
Most recently, I've graduated from the Global Leadership Academy. And having graduated from that, interestingly enough, I was elected the Vice President of the Faculty Senate. After that year-long learning experience about leadership, I'm also invested even further in how do we engage faculty and how do we represent them and how do we help them to integrate into this community, our Webster community, so we can push it forward.
For my sabbatical, I was offered the opportunity to design costumes for Christmas Carol for the Repertory Theater of St. Louis.
My first year seminar took as a project to learn about the Webster Groves community. So I got to learn about Webster Groves, and I got to learn about it through the eyes of my students.
This year I learned how to create a website from scratch, learning the HTML and CSS codes. It adds more to my experience and things that I can add to a company.
I've learned a lot about communications and how to use them both internally with staff and other university employees, and also externally, learning how to communicate better with our alumni population.
As the cybersecurity program lead, I've learned an awful lot about the expectations of what industry requires from students that enter the program.
I've learned that it's very important for you to network, and I've gained a wealth of knowledge within the network by going the extra mile and getting to know more people in the Webster community.
I've been able to use what I learned in the classroom in my recent election to the Webster Staff Alliance Board.
I have been reading more literature about the qualities of leadership, and I've actually learned that through the CIC meeting, through the Global Leadership Academy, and through Dr. Strobel, who really leads by example on this.
I know that this is an indescribably challenging time for a lot of people, particularly people of color. I don't want to be a bystander, and importantly, I'm raising a child. My wife and I are raising a child, and we don't want our son to be a bystander, and so we're reading some of these books to talk about being kind to other people and to being fair to other people and what we can do in our daily lives to make the world just a little bit better for the people around us.
The biggest lesson I learned on sabbatical is that just doing one thing at a time made me find more joy in my artistic work.
Being a part of the GLA, I have learned a lot from my fellow cohort members. I have been connected to them in a way that wouldn't have existed if I had not been here. And I have learned about a lot of resources that are available in this institution that can help students back home.
My wife and I own a 100-year-old home, and believe it or not, I have decided that I'm going to learn how to tuck point.
Now I'm learning what it takes to be in charge, to do all the paperwork, to run a team, and stay as seamless as possible for the students so that we can keep achieving our goals.
So we're always learning new things. It's just who we are.
Well, learning keeps you young.
And there's always just an opportunity to get better at what we do.
But I think another way to frame that is, why is learning a pleasure? And why is curiosity part of intelligence?
Just because they say the sky is the limit, there's always the moon. So you can always go a little higher and stretch yourself a little farther.
There's all sorts of stuff that we do because it's fun, even if we don't do it well. I live with a knitter. She made this sweater. She's good at it now.
I think learning is important because it helps you grow as a person and makes you see what you're fully capable of.
Well, if you stop learning and stop asking questions, where are you? What wakes you up in the morning and gets you out of bed?
I like to think of myself as a lifelong learner. I certainly wouldn't want to be in the classroom if that wasn't something that I took seriously.
And if we, the faculty, can't continue to learn and refresh and find pleasure and joy in what we do, then how can we help our students do that?